Tactical, are they going to make it fast? Walker certainly won't want it to drop too much in the early stages, but it is slow now. Walker will have to make it go because his short acceleration isn't good. He exists, as we saw in the 800 metres when he was knocked out in the first round, off Bill's acceleration. Meanwhile, Eamon Coughlan of Ireland really has got a devastating turn of speed. Three from the back at the moment with Walker. Coughlan lost form earlier this year and he was found to be suffering from anemia, but obviously back at his best. Moorcroft leads for Great Britain. Vollhuter, the tiny American, second. The bearded Frank Clement is third. Wellman, West Germany, four. The tiny Australian Graham Crouch is five. The tough, squally built Hungarian Zeman, six. The black-vested world record holder John Walker, seven. The green vest of Ireland and Eamon Coughlan in eighth place. And at the back, the big Belgian Van Dunn. Very, very slow. 62 seconds. And Walker won't be too happy about that. And Coughlan's moved up as well. Walker goes through with Coughlan. And Coughlan hits the front. The man with the big finish has gone to the front, and it may well be that he wants to slow it down and keep it at this pace, but he seems to have injected a little bit of pace there. But certainly, all the tacticians believe that he would want to sit and wait. But Coughlan leads. Moorcroft, Great Britain in second place. Clement, Great Britain, third. John Walker, four. Vollhuter, five. Zeman, six. Wellman, seven. Van Dam, eight. And right at the back, Graham Crouch of Australia. 800 metres to go. Coughlan really taking them on now. Moorcroft dug in second place. Walker goes third. Clement trapped on the curb. The place you don't want to be, but it's very difficult indeed as the pace changes to get away from those positions. 800 metres, 2-3. So that was a 6-1 second lap. It's not particularly fast. What will Walker do? Will he wait for the finish? Will he go early? Bailly could have solved this problem for him, but Bailly isn't here. Bailly, the dedicated world record holder from Tanzania, dedicated to front running, discards all tactics. For the rest, then, the job's simple. They must either stay with him or die. But there's no one here like that today, and now Walker comes up on the outside to cover any burst. 60, 70 yards to the bell, and what will Walker do? Van Dam moves up to cover Walker. Moorcroft losing his place slightly. Crouch comes up on the outside. Clement on the curb and can't get away. There's the bell. Walker leads. Coughlan second. Vollhuter is there. Crouch is there. Clement is there. And Moorcroft forced back around the outside. He's almost in lane three. Can Clement get off the curb there? He's third at the moment, the Scotsman. Coughlan leads. Walker second. Vollhuter. Bronze medalist, the 800, goes on the outside. But the big man from New Zealand makes it now, a test of strength from 300 out. Through 200, and Walker leads. Van Dam's there as well. Vollhuter right there. Goes past Coughlan. Clement still fighting hard with Wellman. But Walker from New Zealand, the world mile record holder, strikes for Olympic gold. Van Dam second. Wellman comes through the inside. Coughlan's there for Ireland. Clement coming with a late run, but too late. And Walker goes home, as the great New Zealander has done in the past. In second place, Van Dam. And third was Coughlan. Third was Wellman. Fourth, Coughlan. And five, Clement. John Walker joins the great men of New Zealand middle distance running in the Olympic history book. The time, 3:39, but winning was the most important thing. I made Frank Clement back in fifth place and David Moorcroft seventh.
The big strong men out in front now. Van Dam, who was always a threat. Coughlan, really, the Irishman, gets bottled right at as he approaches the tape within 10 yards. Vollhuter looks behind him. He now knows that he's struggling for a place. Look at Wellman with the band across his chest from West Germany. And Frank Clement coming hard. And there's a bang between them, I too. David Moorcroft comes in. Britain wins the team event again. Look at that. Clement bangs Vollhuter, but Walhuter's already tired. Now look as the Irishman tries to close the gap. Van Dam settles for the silver. Wellman's still struggling. That's two silvers for Van Dam, and it's a magnificent gains that he's had. Watch the Irishman trying to find a way through. He's really tilting too far forward, and there he staggers just a little bit as Wellman closes the gap. Walker's only there by a yard when everybody expected him to be a clear favourite.